The truth.
Hey, what's up everyone? It's your boy Rocket456 here today. Welcome back to the channel. I know it has been a very long time since I have uploaded a video, a month in fact, but that's because I basically have been reviewing myself and the channel and what I want as the new direction of the channel, which as you can already tell by this video, I'm going for more like, and also with my channel description and my new YouTube banner, I'm basically going for more gaming, like movies, anime, and like all that stuff, and basically more of a nerd channel. And for the celebration of the new Spider-Man movie coming out, and with all these cool villains that will be in the movie, I'm basically going to be doing a top 10 video right now of my favorite Spider-Man villains of all time. Now, remember, this is my list. This is my opinions. If you have a different, totally different list of what your favorite top 10 Spider-Man villains are, please, please comment below if you have any of your favorites that even favorites that I did not mention in this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let's go get on with my top 10 Spider-Man villains list. My number 10 top villain of Spider-Man is Sandman. And I know this clip is showing Spider-Man right now, but it's just a clip I got. So is Sandman. I really like the Sandman. He's honestly, the way just his powers are really creative, how he can basically form any of his hands and into any weapon he wants. He can go through, like, sand, turning into sand is probably one of the most over, because his only weakness is water. Once you, like, get him into water, like, that's his weakness. And so, like, when you're sand, I mean, you can basically do anything. Like, you can, like, sneak through doors and all this stuff. But his power is cool. His character is very interesting, because, and sometimes he's just a straight up villain and he's like fighting Spider-Man, but then at some points he tries to be good, and it's like, I don't like, and then you question if he's like a villain or an anti-hero. And then, but his story and how, like, especially in the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man 3 movie, how he's like trying to, he's doing it for his daughter. That's like, he really wants to see his daughter, and his daughter's like sick and everything. Like, I just love his whole motive for some stuff, even though he's doing the wrong thing. That's why, like, Spider-Man was trying to be like, you're doing the wrong thing, like, for the wrong reason. Like, you're doing it for the right reason, but, like, the wrong thing. And so that's what makes Sandman a very complex, even though he's like kind of boring on the outside, he's actually a pretty complex villain, and that is why he is my number 10. The next villain on my list is Mysterio, and oh my gosh, what can I say that has not already been said? How Mysterio is so great, like, especially as the way they did it in Far From Home is probably my favorite version of him. And because with his whole illusion thing, it's just amazing. And, like, he really wants to kill Peter Parker. Like, in Far From Home, he doesn't really do that. Like, at first, like, he doesn't want to kill Peter Parker. But, like, in the actual, like, comics and other storylines of Mysterio, he really does hate Peter Parker, like, as a vengeance. Because he's always, like, messing up his plans and everything. And so, he really wants to kill Peter Parker. And, or Spider-Man. And how he, like, manipulates Peter Parker. And it's just, man. And especially in Far From Home, how he manipulated him so much. and with the illusion tech and how like he was able to get Stark's glasses. Like, that's just, people like don't really usually know how powerful Mysterio can be. And he, because he's very manipulative, his illusions look so real. And it's, man, it's just awesome. And especially with watching this clip from Far From Home, you can see how crazy and amazing his illusions are. And it definitely throws Peter or Spider-Man into loop every time they face each other because of how great his illusions are. And the fact that he just wants to really murder Peter Parker. So, yeah, that's number 9 on my list, which is the next villain I definitely want to talk about, which is number 8, is Kingpin. Kingpin is an amazing villain that, honestly, he doesn't even have any powers, but he is definitely one of Spider-Man's greatest threats. And every time Spider-Man is shown Kingpin, like, against Kingpin, it is definitely a threat to Spider-Man. Because, in the public, Kingpin is not actually seen as a bad guy to people. People actually think he is actually a good person. But, obviously, we know that he is not, and a good person at all. And he always seems like he's one step ahead of Spider-Man. Like, every single time Spider-Man tries to get Kingpin arrested or whatever, he always finds a way to escape or just not at all, like, get caught by Spider-Man. And he's a schemer. It's just crazy how smart he can be, to how he can get out of any situation. And he, like I said, he's always one step ahead of Spider-Man most of the time, and he's just an amazing villain. I guess he kind of does have super strength. I don't know, like, because when he is fighting Spider-Man, there is sometimes he shows like he has super strength, but I don't know for sure on that. But he is definitely one of my favorite Spider-Man villains, and is definitely number 8 on my list. This villain that is on my list, which is number 7, is the Lizard, aka Dr. Connors. And, oh man, this villain is very, very complex. Even though some people may not realize how complex he is a very complex villain. For one, Peter doesn't really want to hurt the Lizard. Like, he really doesn't want to, like, kill him, because he did have a personal relationship with Dr. Connors. In some storylines, he is like an intern for Dr. Connors. In other storylines, he like helps out at his lab a couple times. And he just really is a good friend to Dr. Connors. And when he did turn into the Lizard, he really did not want to hurt him. Like, just, and plus, he's super smart. Even when he's sort of in Lizard form, he still has some sort of smarts with being a doctor, obviously, with chemistry and stuff. He sort of still has it. And, like, he can make crazy weapons with his smartness. And plus, he just hides in the sewer. He has, like, a sewer lab, which is really cool. Just the sewer lab. Not the sewer part, per se, but just having an underground lab where he makes, like, all his, like, stuff is definitely very cool. He kind of has the same powers as Spider-Man, besides, like, with the web-slinging and stuff. He still has, like, super strength, and he can crawl on walls. I'm not sure about that, but I think so. I don't know. Correct me in the comments if I'm wrong. But he is just I love the Lizard. And
I'm not gonna lie. I mean, yes, his. Oh, I forgot. He also has regenerating powers. As I'm watching this clip right now, he has regenerating powers. Because obviously he is a lizard. But, I mean, I do actually like what the Amazing Spider-Man did with the lizard. Even though I don't like the movie in general, I do like what they did with the lizard. I thought that was really cool and an amazing idea. But that is my number seven favorite Spider-Man villain, the Lizard. So my number six on this list is, as you can already tell by the clip, is the Vulture. And the Vulture is always Spider-Man's like first ever like real supervillain in the TV shows, and also in Homecoming, he was his first Spider-Man villain to really go against. And the Vulture, he's very, like, especially with his flying tech, it's definitely hard for Spider-Man to fight him, especially if he can just grab Spider-Man and just, like, fly like 1,000 feet and then drop him. And especially if Spider-Man's like out of web fluid and stuff, definitely would be very dangerous for him. And so that's why I like the Vulture. And also he has a complex story that not a lot of people know about, because the tech, like the fly tech that he actually uses, actually gives him like cancer or whatever. And it's actually killing him. So a lot of people don't know that. But yeah, definitely a unique villain, and definitely my number six Spider-Man villain on my list. The number five villain that is on my list is Electro. Now, why Electro is one of my entering my top five list of this list is because his powers to me are just amazing. I love his costume and his powers of controlling electricity, especially in a modern setting where almost everything is powered by electricity. He has a lot of power with controlling electricity. Also, because of him, he worked for Dr. Connors at one point, and that was in like the Spectacular Spider-Man cartoon. He was working with Dr. Connors as like his electrician or whatever, and that like made Peter have a personal connection with Electro, with him working with Connors. And he's just an amazing villain. He doesn't have complex goals. Like, he just wants to take over the world, or like with his electric powers and stuff, and like influence people or whatever. Like, take over the world, because in his eyes, especially in The Amazing Spider-Man 2, the world like did him wrong, and he wants to like have revenge on the world because they like embarrassed him or whatever. But yeah, that's it for my number five, which is Electro. The next villain on my list, which is more of a newer one, well, not a newer one, he has been in the Spider-Man comics before, but which is Mr. Negative, or Martin Lee, whatever you want to call him. But his backstory, like, let's go ahead and get into his backstory. Like, Norman and Dr. Otto Octavius like worked on him because they were trying to like cure something, and like they thought like whatever they were do I don't remember the exact specifics, but they thought like whatever they were doing would like help cure him of like some disease or whatever. But it actually ended up killing his parents in the process of them trying to help him. And man, like, that's just sad. And so of course he has a red hot vengeance for Norman Osborn, Because Dr. Octavius actually tried, went before he was Dr. Octopus, actually tried to stop the experiment. And but Norman obviously wanted to keep on going. But of course, so he wasn't really that mad at Norman, I mean at Dr. Octavius per se, more on Norman. So yeah, and his powers are cool because he can like turn people like really mad at each other, and it kind of, especially in the Spider-Man game, it definitely holds Spider-Man off like from trying to chase him down. But overall, he's a very strong villain and has very complex goals and an amazing backstory. So that is it for my number four. So my number three on my list is Venom. I really love Venom. Like when it's Black Spider-Man and he's like with the symbiote suit, and when he's Eddie Brock, or anytime Venom is a part of a Spider-Man's like story, it's never bad, except Spider-Man 3. Anyway, keep that comment to myself because there is a video I'm planned to do, but of course I won't reveal what I will be doing with it later. Anyway, back on Venom. So Venom is great as a villain because one, he just has he for one, he knows Spider-Man's identity because of him being bonded to Spider-Man. Like he knows his identity, and that makes him very dangerous because he could tell the whole world or whatever that Spider-Man is Peter Parker, which obviously puts a lot of people in danger. And so, which is very bad for Peter Parker. And then also, he has basically the same powers as Spider-Man, and he has super strength. He can crawl on walls. He's just an amazing villain. So recently, they've been showing him as like an anti-hero, which I'm totally fine with Venom being an anti-hero. I just feel like when he's in the villain role, he has more like complex goals and is more like important. But overall, he is a great villain and definitely number three on my list. The next villain on my list, which is number two, is Dr. Otto Octavius, or Dr. Octopus, whatever you want to call him. He is definitely deserves number two on my list because he is the smartest villain out of all the Spider-Man villains. He like his plans and goals in the series or in the Spider-Man lore is very, very like complex, and like the his metal arms are like crazy powerful, and it's, man, I'm basically speechless trying to come up of all the great things that makes Dr. Octopus an amazing villain. And he had actually a connection with Peter, and before he became Dr. Octopus, like he was an in, like he worked with him, or like he was an intern, like Spider-Man PS4, he was worked for him. But he is, man, I love Dr. Octavius, and I'm so glad they're giving him another chance with the original actor in No Way Home. And oh man, just love Dr. Octavius, and it's definitely number two on my list. Now, the moment you have been waiting for, the number one villain, number one Spider-Man villain that is on my list is the Green Goblin. Honestly, every time the Green Goblin shows up in like a storyline or in a cartoon or even a movie, it's always a big event when he's around. Like, it's usually, especially if it's a cartoon or whatever, it is a multi-part episode. Like, the Green Goblin, you know it's special when he shows up. For one, Norman Osborn and Peter Parker have a very personal relationship with each other because of, obviously, Norman Osborn's son, Harry. And Harry is Peter's best friend. And, like, him fighting the Green Goblin and doing all that stuff, really, because he's, like, you being a villain and stuff is hurting, like, his son. And, of course, with the Green Goblin, like, the Green Goblin himself influencing Norman, like, he doesn't really care. Like, he's crazy. Like, the Green Goblin is kind of Spider-Man, like, Marvel's version of the Joker. Like, the Green Goblin is, like, an alter version of Spider-Man. Like, he's smart, he's crazy, he has no morals at all, and he just, like, blows everything up. Like, as this scene in the original Spider-Man 1, bam, vaporizes those people. Like, he is just crazy. And, of course, I love him in Spider-Man 1. William Dafoe as the Green Goblin is just amazing. And I'm so glad that William Dafoe is reprising his role as the Green Goblin in No Way Home. It's just going to be amazing. And like I said, because Norman and Peter, like, know each other, the Green Goblin and Spider-Man, it's a very personal fight. Like, it's always, like, personal with the Green Goblin. And, man, I just love the Green Goblin, and I can't talk enough about it. If I would keep on talking about the Green Goblin, we would be here all day. So, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, please make sure to subscribe. When you subscribe, make sure to press the notification bell. When you press the notification bell, make sure to press all. And also, don't forget in the comments, if you have a different list for your favorite Spider-Man villains, please put that in the comments. And as always, thanks so much for watching, and peace, Rocket 456, and have a Spidey fantastic day.